Let's say we have an expression like n plus n plus 1 plus n plus 2 and goes to the a. How are we supposed to find the sum of them? Of course, with the help of Sir Gauss. I suppose you have heard about the little Gauss method. Let's say we have a sequence of numbers that starts from 1 to n and we need to find the sum of this series. Gauss says the sum of these numbers is n multiplied by n plus 1 divided by 2. And we need to apply this to our expression. For that, we need another series which starts from 1 and goes to the a. Let's call this x and call the whole series y. Now, we need to find y minus x to find the sum of our expression. If we apply Gauss' method, x would be equal to n multiplied by n minus 1 divided by 2. And with the same logic, y would be equal to a multiplied by a plus 1 divided by 2. Then we have something like a multiplied by a plus 1 divided by 2 minus n minus 1 multiplied by n divided by 2. Now if we do multiplications, we would have something like a to the second power plus a minus n to the second power minus n divided by 2. And let's clear this mess up. Now we have a to the second power minus n to the second power plus a minus n divided by 2. According to the difference of squares, we know that a to the second power minus n to the second power equals a minus n multiplied by a plus n. Now our expression became something like a minus n times a plus n plus a minus n divided by 2. But we know a minus n is common, so if we do common factoring, we get our perfect result, which is a minus n plus 1 multiplied by n plus n divided by 2.